Good morning. Again, it's good to be with you good people, and I have been thinking about this coronavirus and the situation that we're all in, and it's a difficult time, but it's a time of reflecting maybe on the things that we need to keep and hold precious, and it's also a time to get rid of the stuff that we don't need that is not important. Maybe it's just a time for us to kick back a little bit because of having to stay home so much and just think about what really is important and put our priorities straight. I want to read to you from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 25, specifically verse 31, where it says, "When the Son of Man comes as king and all the angels with him, he will sit on his royal throne." We're living in a day of grace, but the time will come, of course, when every person will stand before Christ on Judgment Day. Today, Christ calls for lost people to accept his mercy and be saved. But the day is coming when he will say to those who have rejected his mercy, and he'll just simply tell them to get away from him. Today, Christ is the Savior. Then, in that day, he will be judged. His first coming was like a lamb. His second coming will be that of a lion. Christ will be sitting on a throne surrounded by angels when the Son of Man comes as king. Something to think about, good people. Something that we need to realize and accept his wonderful grace and his awesome mercy right here and right now. I want to tell you about a story. A horse pulling a wagon bolted and ran away in a frontier town way back in the day, carrying a little boy. A young man saw that the child was in danger and risked his life to catch the horse and stop the wagon. The little boy grew up and then became a criminal. And one day he stood before a judge to be sentenced for a serious felony. The prisoner recognized the judge as the man who, years before, had saved his life. So he pleaded for mercy on the basis of that experience. But the words from the bench silenced his plea. "Young man, then I was your savior. Today, I am your judge, and I must sentence you to be hanged." Jesus Christ will one day say to rebellious sinners, "During that long day of grace, I was the Savior, and I would have forgiven you. But today I am your judge. Depart from me." And as you depart, you will depart into everlasting fire. God's gift of salvation must be received before Christ becomes judge. Grace will no longer be extended when the Son of Man comes as king. Let's remember that, and let's do the right thing always. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we do thank you for each and every day, and we know it to be a gift from you. Help us, Lord, to stay on that path that you have specifically designed for each and every one of us. Help us, Heavenly Father, to walk in the light always. Be with us. Help us to always be willing to help others, even if it's through a phone call or a card or a letter or maybe a visit. But be with us, Heavenly Father, and help us to accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior. Help us to do that, Lord, each and every day. And it's in his precious name that we pray these things. Amen. God bless each and every one of you. And have a great day.
My faithful Father, enduring friend, your tender mercies like a river with no end. It overwhelms me. Covers my sin. Each time I come into your presence, I stand in wonder once again. Your grace still amazes me. Your love is still a mystery each day. I fall on stronger.